The science fiction story begins by explaining that thousands of years ago, when dinosaurs roamed the Earth, very large meteorites started falling from space. These massive meteorites had an effect equivalent to 100 atomic bombs, which completely destroyed all the dinosaur species on Earth. We then see a NASA astronaut on the International Space Station working on some repairs. Everything was being controlled from NASA's headquarters on Earth when suddenly, a large number of small meteorites began to fall on the astronaut. These meteorites were so dangerous and fast that the astronaut didn't even have a chance to save himself. The entire International Space Station and all spacecraft were damaged, and now all connections with NASA headquarters were lost. When NASA scientists became aware of this, they immediately started investigating. They couldn't understand what had happened to cause their connection to be lost. To find out, they reviewed footage from the cameras attached to the astronaut's suit and discovered that something had passed by very quickly, which had destroyed the entire space station. However, NASA had no idea what this object was. They quickly began their investigation. Next, we are shown New York City, where everyone was living comfortably. However, very large stones started falling from the sky onto New York City. This caused widespread devastation. The US president and the entire government believed that this was a missile attack by enemy countries. However, confirmation from NASA headquarters clarified that these were not missiles, but meteorites that were falling on Earth after so many years. The president instructed NASA to conduct a deep investigation into these events. When scientists observed space through the Hubble Space Telescope, they discovered that a very large meteorite was continuously approaching Earth. Estimates suggested that this meteorite was even larger than New York City. The president was informed about all these developments. Therefore, the government officials quickly held a meeting to discuss how to prevent the impending disaster. The president asked NASA scientists about when and where the meteorite would land. The scientists explained that the meteorite was so large that if it accidentally collided with Earth, it would destroy the entire planet. Additionally, based on the meteorite's speed and structure, the scientists estimated that it would enter Earth's orbit within 18 to 20 days, meaning they had only 20 days to find a way to prevent it. Officers discussed whether they could destroy the massive meteorite. One idea was to attach a nuclear bomb to it, which might destroy it, but a NASA scientist argued that this would not be effective. A nuclear bomb would only remove a part of the meteorite, not completely destroy it. Then, another scientist named Ronald suggested that if they could drill into the meteorite and insert multiple nuclear bombs, detonating them in the core could cause the meteorite to shatter. This strategy was approved by all the NASA scientists, but the challenge was to find workers who could drill into the meteorite. We are then introduced to a worker named Harry, who had been working at an oil mining factory for years. Harry went to a boy named AJ, who was very angry because AJ had had an affair with his daughter, Grace. This situation deeply troubled Harry, making him question whether AJ was a suitable partner for his daughter. Shortly after, some US military personnel arrived at the location and wanted to include Harry in their mission because he had 30 years of drilling experience, which NASA needed to complete their mission. The NASA organization, in collaboration with the government, had decided that they needed to drill into the meteorite and destroy it from within. Therefore, Harry was summoned to NASA's headquarters. Harry brought his daughter Grace with him to ensure she wouldn't meet AJ. The president personally met with Harry to explain everything. The president explained to Harry and his daughter Grace that a meteorite as large as New York City was expected to collide with Earth in just a few days. They needed to undertake a mission to eliminate it by any means necessary. The plan was to send a team of astronauts to the meteorite to drill into it and insert numerous nuclear bombs. If the core of the meteorite was completely blasted, the meteorite itself would shatter. The scientists believed this was the only safe and effective way to save Earth. Although Harry was not interested in any NASA missions, The situation had escalated to the survival of Earth and all its inhabitants. If Earth were to be destroyed, his survival would be meaningless. The president wanted Harry to provide thorough drilling training to the astronauts who would be going on the mission. However, Harry said that with over 20 years of drilling experience, it was impossible to train NASA astronauts in such a short time to drill effectively. Furthermore, the drilling would not be on solid ground but on a meteorite, requiring a high level of precision. After explaining everything, Harry requested the president to allow him and his team to go into space to complete the mission. He emphasized that any mistake could lead to the destruction of the entire Earth. Seeing Harry's confidence, the president agreed to move forward with the mission. Harry then called his drilling team, who would be part of the mission. NASA astronauts began checking the team to ensure they were ready for space travel. After several hours of examination, the scientists confirmed that all were fit for the mission, though they lacked significant space experience. The president, aware of the limited time available, approved Harry and his team for the mission. However, before proceeding, the astronauts needed to complete basic training to help Harry's team stabilize in space. Now, a military colonel was briefing Harry's entire team about their mission. They had only 12 days left to reach the meteorite, and within these 12 days, the entire team had to complete basic astronaut training. First, the colonel took Harry's team to the spacecraft that they would use to reach the meteorite. There were two advanced spacecraft, built from very strong materials. Controlling them was highly complicated, so some astronauts would accompany them as pilots for this mission. Harry's team quickly began intense training. They were given zero-gravity experiences in a swimming pool to help them adapt to the discomfort of space. In no time, 10 days had passed, and their training was complete. The president then explained to Harry's team how they would reach the meteorite. Initially, after leaving Earth, they would need to stop at the Russian space station to refill gases and fuel. After that, they would head directly towards the meteorite, drill several feet into it, and insert nuclear bombs. However, the bombs needed to be detonated before reaching Earth's distance. If the meteorite was destroyed within the distance determined by scientists, many fragments would fall to Earth, causing even more devastation. If they destroyed it before reaching this distance, the fragments would be sent away from Earth. With everything carefully planned, Harry's team was ready to go into space. Meanwhile, fragments of the large meteorite began falling on several eastern countries, indicating that the massive meteorite was approaching rapidly. Following government orders, Harry's team set off for space. The president and government officials urged everyone to pray for the survival of Earth. Harry's team boarded the two spacecraft named Independent and Freedom to commence their mission. They all reached space with the help of their rockets. According to the plan, they first need to stop at the Russian space station to refuel. Both spacecraft dock at the Russian space station for refueling. However, Harry notices that there is already a slight fuel leak at the station. While trying to fix it, two of Harry's team members get trapped on the other side. The rest of Harry's team makes a frantic effort to rescue them, but the fuel leak causes a short circuit in the station, leading to a fire. Harry quickly orders his team to evacuate. The team splits up, boards the two spacecraft, and leaves the space station. The members of both spacecraft head towards the meteorite. However, the Russian space station is completely destroyed, causing a significant loss for the Russian government. Harry's team continues to advance towards the massive meteorite. Although both space shuttles reach the meteorite, small fragments from the large meteorite keep colliding with the spacecraft. Avoiding these fragments proves to be very challenging. The Freedom space shuttle, which carries Harry and his team, manages to dodge the fragments and keep their shuttle safe. However, the Independent space shuttle suffers numerous collisions with meteorite fragments and becomes completely disabled. The team on the Independent shuttle loses contact with the other team. Realizing that they cannot survive, the members of the Independent Shuttle tell the people aboard the Freedom spacecraft that the responsibility to save Earth now rests with them. After this, the Freedom Space Shuttle loses control and crashes into the large meteorite, destroying itself. All the members of the Independent Space Shuttle are killed. Harry, with the remaining team, continues to move forward as quickly as possible, but their spacecraft is also in very bad condition. At one point, the connection with NASA's headquarters was completely lost. Although the scientists were trying to re-establish contact, Harry and his team had already landed the Freedom spacecraft elsewhere. Due to the deteriorating conditions, Harry ordered that they land on the meteorite. The scientists had provided Harry's team with a proper landing position on the meteorite where they needed to start drilling immediately. Unfortunately, when Harry's team landed their spacecraft, they ended up far from the designated drilling spot. Upon realizing this, Harry decided that they could not return to the correct spot as it would consume too much time. Therefore, he instructed the team to start drilling at their current location. The team began excavation with all their gadgets and equipment, but the part of the meteorite they landed on was so hard that their machines broke down after a short time. Seeing this, Harry and his team felt helpless because they could no longer drill into the meteorite. Meanwhile, NASA's headquarters was trying to contact the astronauts. They received a signal from the Independent Space Shuttle, where a few people had survived. This was the same space shuttle that had crashed onto the meteorite. Fortunately, the shuttle was not too high on the meteorite, which minimized the damage. Only three astronauts survived, and they decided to continue with the mission. AJ was also still alive among them. AJ and the others investigated what was left in their Independent Space Shuttle. Luckily, they found another drilling machine and all necessary equipment. They needed to reach Harry and his remaining team, so AJ and the others began heading to the other side of the meteorite with all the equipment. Meanwhile, Harry was trying to drill with his team. Although they had managed to drill to some depth, many parts of their drilling machine were breaking. The strength of the meteorite was so great that this part was very dense. At NASA headquarters, when it was revealed that Harry had not drilled to the required depth to insert the nuclear bomb, and with only 6 hours left to complete the task, the president and others began to get frustrated with Harry for not working faster. However, Harry assured them that with his years of experience, they should trust him. He promised to complete the drilling and detonate the nuclear bomb before the given time, risking his life to save the Earth. After motivating his team, they began drilling with renewed urgency. But the drilling machine was under so much pressure that it short-circuited, and a part of it exploded. At this point, an earthquake started on the meteorite, causing the remaining drilling equipment to be completely destroyed. During these events, one of Harry's teammates also lost his life, and the team was left without any equipment to continue drilling. Harry called NASA headquarters in a state of despair and informed them that they would not be able to save Earth because they had no other option but to detonate the nuclear bomb on the surface. This might also endanger the lives of everyone present. Harry had completely lost hope. Meanwhile, time was running out. The meteorite came so close to Earth that it could be seen with the naked eye. Small meteorite fragments were falling to Earth with such speed that they had destroyed several large cities in one go, causing explosions in multiple locations simultaneously. Scientists had determined that only 3 hours were left before the meteorite would cross the barrier, and if it did, destroying it would not prevent Earth's destruction. At this moment, Harry, who was despondent, suddenly heard someone shouting. When he turned around, he saw his other team, which included additional survivors, arriving with a rover. Harry went over to AJ and the others. Harry then discovers that the rover contains another drilling machine and all the necessary equipment, which means they could still drill into the meteorite and plant the nuclear bomb. This realization rekindles a glimmer of hope among Harry and the others. Without delay, They activate all the parts of the drilling machine and begin drilling into the meteorite. AJ cleverly performs a small blast underground first, which softens the upper layer of the meteorite. This makes the drilling process significantly easier. They drill continuously for several minutes and eventually reach the depth specified by the scientists. They only need to place the nuclear bomb inside the hole now. AJ begins to carry the bomb into the hole, but the situation takes a turn. The large meteorite has moved so close to Earth that Earth's gravitational force is now affecting it. The speed of the meteorite has doubled due to this gravitational force, and small fragments are falling around it, causing significant problems for Harry's team. AJ is unable to place the nuclear bomb in the hole and has to retreat due to the explosion, seeking safety inside the spacecraft. The team has only 40 minutes left to detonate the nuclear bomb and escape. Suddenly, they receive news from NASA headquarters that the detonator and the remote-controlled nuclear bomb are completely malfunctioning. This means that someone has to stay behind to activate the bomb manually. Everyone is shocked by this revelation because now one of them will have to sacrifice their life to stay with the bomb. After much deliberation, they decide that rather than having one person sacrifice themselves, it would be better if they all sacrifice themselves together. To determine who will stay behind to activate the bomb, they decide to play a small game. Everyone drew straws one by one, and the person who drew the shortest straw would stay behind with the bomb and sacrifice their life. When everyone had drawn their straws, it was revealed that AJ's straw was the shortest, meaning AJ would be the one to stay behind and activate the nuclear bomb. After the decision, AJ and Harry descended to the location where the bomb needed to be planted. AJ told Harry to let his daughter, Grace, know that he would always be with her, even though he was sacrificing his life. Harry saw a protective gleam in AJ's eyes towards his daughter. When they reached the spot, AJ said goodbye to Harry, knowing he was about to die. But suddenly, Harry pushed AJ and removed his oxygen tube, sending him back to the lift, meaning Harry would stay behind to activate the bomb and AJ would return to the team. Harry requested AJ to marry Grace after he returned and keep her happy forever. AJ, feeling helpless, quickly went back to the rest of the team. Harry made a video call to NASA headquarters, apologizing to his daughter that he would never return from this mission. He gave Grace permission to marry AJ and live her life with him. The video call ended, and Grace was heartbroken after hearing her father's message. The rest of the team, aboard the Freedom spacecraft, quickly prepared to land on Earth. With only 40 seconds left before the meteorite entered the designated distance, Harry activated the nuclear bomb. The explosion inside the meteorite was so massive that it split into two pieces before reaching the critical distance, causing the pieces to drift away from Earth. The smaller fragments were completely destroyed, meaning Harry had sacrificed his life to save all of humanity. The people of Earth were extremely happy with the outcome, and with this happy ending, our story comes to a close.